విభజన తీరుపై కాంగ్రెస్ ను విమర్శిస్తున్న ప్రధాని మోదీ తన హామీలను మాత్రం ఎందుకు నిలబెట్టుకోలేకపోయారని చంద్రబాబు ప్రశ్నించారు. రాష్ట్రాన్ని కాంగ్రెస్ పార్టీ విభజిస్తే ఆ విభజనలో భాగమైన బీజేపీ రాష్ట్రానికి ద్రోహం చేస్తుందన్నారు. అప్పటి ప్రధాని ఇచ్చిన హామీలను అమలు చేయాల్సిన బాధ్యత కేంద్రంపై లేదా అని ప్రశ్నించారు చంద్రబాబు.
But it is not your responsibility what you promised, you have to keep it up. In your own words you told all these things. You blamed Congress. You have forgotten your responsibility. How can you justify all these things, I am asking you. After 4 years.
లోక్సభలో ప్రధాని ప్రత్యేక హోదాపై చేసిన వ్యాఖ్యలను చంద్రబాబు తప్పుబట్టారు. 14వ ఆర్థిక సంఘాన్ని సాకుగా చూపి హోదా ఇవ్వలేదన్న ప్రధాని మాటలు సత్యదూరం అన్న చంద్రబాబు 14వ ఆర్థిక సంఘం కారణంగా ప్రత్యేక ఆర్థిక సంఘం ఎప్పుడు ఆ మాట చెప్పలేదని గుర్తు చేశారు. ఇదేనా కేంద్రం రాష్ట్రాల సంబంధాల కొనసాగింపు అంటూ ఆవేదన వ్యక్తం చేశారు.
From NDA we came out. If you see here very clearly, yesterday if you see, first of all they told me they will give special status. After some time they told me we are not giving special status for anybody, there are problems, so we will give equal to special status benefits to you. This also we are not extending anybody. And also even finance commission there are some constraints. And also they told me because of all these things there is GST is coming. Even existing industrial incentives to other states also will be lapsed. That is the impression, that is the message they gave me. Ultimately 11 states they have given special status, same benefits that our people have explained. Now yesterday PM told very clearly, it is because of 14th Finance Commission I am unable to extend this benefit. I am asking Honorable Prime Minister, where they told you about this? What is the reaction, what is the constraint for you? Never they mentioned this. If you see here Govindra, member 14th Finance Commission, he mentioned very clearly, nowhere has the Finance Commission referred to the issue of desirability or of according special category status in its report. Therefore, attributing blame to the FFC for the inability to accord special category status is clearly misleading. This was entirely an executive decision. Neither the constitution nor the FFC have had anything to do with this. What Prime Minister has to say now? You are dragging the Finance Commission. They are saying don't drag us. We are here only to decide devolution of funds between the center and states. We don't have any role in this. It is the decision of the government of India to take a call and then you can give or execute decision. That is what they mentioned. For this I am asking, is it a fair way of dealing things? Is it the trust we are talking? As Prime Minister, is it the way of maintaining states and relations? Or otherwise, is it the way of dealing what you have promised? So this is where we have moved